An angry open letter urging Chinese Australians to take down the far-right Liberal Party ruling party by voting against John Alexander in the Bulog by-election has been shared on social media by a man who allegedly met the Chinese Communist Party's department tasked with overseas influence activities. The 1700-word letter, attributed to a group of Chinese who call Australia home, urged people to support Labor's candidate, Kristen Akeley. When we look at the Liberal Party, we see it's already totally different from before. It's a far-right ruling party and they are privately against China, against Chinese, against ethnic Chinese migrants and against Chinese international students, it reads in part. For the interests of Chinese people, let us mobilize, share this message and use the ballots in the hands of we Chinese to take down this far-right Liberal Party ruling party. The letter emphasizes how crucial the Bulog by-election was for the nation and Chinese community. Let us say, together, vote against the Liberal Party, protect the dignity of we Chinese. It says. While it is not known who authored the letter, it is being shared on the popular Chinese social media app WeChat by Yan Ziwa, an Australian citizen who lives in Sydney. Mr. Yan is Vice President of the Australian Council for the Promotion of Peaceful Reunification of China, which was until recently run by controversial Chinese political donor Huang Xiaoyagmo and has a parent group in China run by officials from the United Front Work Department, a Chinese Communist Party body responsible for building overseas influence. Mr. Yan most recently met with a United Front Work Department official in October this year. At a 2012 meeting with officials from the department, he was urged him to use his Chinese community group, the Australia-Shanghai Friendship Club, to build deeper ties between Chinese Australians and China and promote China-Australia friendship, according to an article on a Shanghai government website. And a report from the Shanghai Business Federation notes that Mr. Yan also met with United Front Work Department officials in 2013 as part of a Peaceful Reunification Council delegation. The letter also accused the Liberal Party of breaking down mutual trust with China and of being hostile in the South China Sea. As soon as there are issues with the Australia-China friendship, trade between the countries will decline. Speaking with Fairfax Media, Mr. Yan initially denied having met with anyone from the United Front Work Department but later said he may have ran into some at events in Australia and Shanghai. It doest really matter, it's not an issue, Mr. Yan said. Zhong Hunning, a member of the Sydney Chinese community acquainted with Yan Ziwa, said that local Chinese associations have been working hard to encourage Chinese to vote for Ms. Keeley. These hometown associations are close to the Overseas Chinese Affairs Office, a Chinese government body engaged in United Front work, Mr. Zhong said. China's president, Lee Jinping, has described United Front work as a magic weapon, and the secretive department's importance within the party has been elevated with this renewed emphasis on its mission, which includes overseas influence activities. The letter appears to reflect growing tensions between the Chinese and Australian governments as Australia has begun taking action against perceived undue influence in Australia by China.